City Dog Show, starring that lovable lawman with a badge of tin and a heart of gold, good old Deputy Dog.
Come back here, you food-grabbing varmint, you!
So get ready now for some real fun and excitement as Muskie and Vincent Van Gogh keep old Deputy busy with some fast-moving, laugh-provoking adventures.
Hello there, you all. This is the old lawman, Deputy Dog. I wear the legal star on my chest, and I'm the legal star of this cotton-picking show. Me and my natural-born buddies, Muskrat, Vincent Van Gogh, and Tycoon, are all set to bring you a passel of rib-tickling and hair-raising adventures. So you all get comfortable out there, because here we go!
There's plenty more fun and excitement coming up on the Deputy Dog Show. So, you stay right next to your TV set while we bring you another fast-moving adventure, which I just know you're going to enjoy. It's one of my favorites.
It's your move there, Deputy Dog.
Now, don't rush me, Muskrat. Let's see. Watch this cotton picking move. Hey!
Deputy Dog. Deputy Dog. I just saw a big monster huffing and puffing smoking, chewing up the whole forest.
You trying to tell me, Gopher, that you saw a monster over there? He doesn't look like one of them there big hysterical monsters. Look at the size of them choppers.
Deputy Dog, it's your legal right and duty to protect us poor helpless folk.
What about this here poor helpless folk?
Maybe that poor old prehysterical monster is friendly-like. Him all alone in a strange place with no one to call a friend.
You're right, Muskie. Poor old prehysterical monster.
Now you be real friendly like there, Deputy Dog.
Greetings there, friend. On behalf of all the folks, I'm here to welcome you to...
Bye-bye, friend.
Is that you, Deputy Dog?
There ain't no Deputy Dog here. Just a little old scared rabbit.
Oh, me. When the sheriff hears old Deputy Dog got scared off like a cotton-picking cottontail, he'll take away old Deputy's badge.
Now, hold on there, Muskie. Nobody's taking away my badge. I'm still the law around here. I'll show that old monster. Just call me Cottontail.
Come on there, Deputy Dog. Lay the law down to him, boy.
According to the statutes of the limitation, no monster shall act unfriendly-like to any one of the first part, namely me, and second part being you. Help! Help! He's a-chopping on the tail, boom!
Let go there, you pre-hysterical varmint, you!
Chase fire! Chase fire!
You all right there, Deputy Dog?
I've been thinking. That old monster's gotta sleep sometime.
Good idea there, Muskie! I'll capture him tonight while he's snoozing. He's asleep. I got him. I got him. Oops.
Oh, wait. He done woke the monster up.
Stop in the name of the law! All right, then, I'm taking you to the jailhouse!
Hang on there, Deputy Dog.
Good thing you showed up, Sheriff. Old Deputy Dog done got himself a pre-hysterical monster.
Is that your mission, Steam Shovel, mister?
That's it, Sheriff.
Stop, you cotton-picking monster! Stop, I said! Deputy Dog, come back here with that steam shovel!
Boy, it's been swallowed up the sheriff! Don't worry no more, Sheriff! I'll save you!
I guess I should. That pre-hysterical monster who's bought. Huh, Sheriff? Got room enough in the woods till this blows over, Musty?
Be my guest, Deputy Dog. Be my guest.
Hey, Mighty Mouse, what's this? Woo!
Wonderful!
It's new power-packed Colgate Dental Cream. You just push the button and zoomy, out it comes.
You mean like this? With just one little touch of the finger?
Sure, that's all it takes.
Well, let's show everyone watching how to use power-packed Colgate. Ready? Here comes your very own container of wonderful new power-packed Colgate Dental Cream with Guardall. And boys and girls, what a lot of fun you can have filling your toothbrush with Colgate from this great new container. What a lot of protection you get, too, because of all leading toothpastes, only Colgate contains Guardall to form an invisible protective shield around your teeth. Fights tooth decay all day. So ask Mom to get Colgate with Guardall in the tube or new push-button containers. It's the world's favorite toothpaste, and mine, too.
Take it from me, Mighty Mouse. When you're on the go all day, you don't always eat as good as you should. That's why I recommend Zest-Tabs. Mom, one Zest-Tab gives a kid most of the vitamins he needs for a whole day. Excuse me. And kids, Zest-Tabs are good to eat. They come in five delicious flavors. Want to see me eat one myself? Okay, I'll eat one myself. Cherry. Delicious, gang. Better than cheese.
Zest-Tabs and Zest-Tabs with iron. Endorsed by one of the strongest guys in the world.
Kids, if you send the name from a Zest-Tab package and 50 cents to Mighty Mouse, Nutley, New Jersey, I'll send you a bigger-than-life-size poster of myself.
It all started one bright moonlight night as the little farmers of Mouseville were enjoying themselves after a happy harvest.
Run for your lives!
Quick, somebody turn on the radio!
A strange object is approaching the Earth. No one knows what to expect. Take every precaution.
Thank you.
because he wants to be friendly.
So the mouse citizens took the strange newcomer to one of their foremost professors, who had a way of understanding strange languages.
Now we will find out what you are talking about. I will test your language on my fish and monster gurgle interpreting machine. Just wait till my father gets here.
His father?
My father is 20 feet high and 10 feet wide. And when he's mad, he tears up houses and trees and breathes fire. Here comes Papa now.
The mice tried desperately to defend themselves. As things looked, well, not too good. Their message finally reached that champion order, protector of the weak, guardian of outer space. Mighty Mouse.
That spells real trouble.
Flashing through the sky at rocket speed, his mighty fist poised for action, the great mouse headed for Mouseville. Sent both of them hurtling around the world. And so, thanks to Mighty Mouse, the little farmers went back to their desks, confident that they would never again have another visitor from outer space.
I wish you never got interested in making clay statues. You don't go out and play and have adventures anymore, Gumby.
Being a sculptor is fun. It's full of surprises.
Fun? Surprises? You can have it. Looks more like work to me. Yipes! Look behind you, Gumby.
Being a sculptor is dangerous, too.
You should have listened to me. Yipes! Gumby, look!
Let's go in that quick! Now, watch me lose it.
No use, Gumby. It's still coming.
Well, I'll try something more drastic. Hold on.
That did it, Gumby. Now will you play, Gumby?
You win, Pokey. Making statues is not as much fun as I thought. Let's see.
Yipes! Gumby, look!
Well, there's only one thing left to do. Take cover, Pokey!
Gumby, I know someone who can help.
Who?
Marshall Dill Pickle.
Of course. Why didn't I think of him? Let's go.
It sure feels good to be back in my old hometown.
Well, Marshall Dill Pickle isn't in his office.
Oh, I remember now. It's time for the morning goodie break. He's probably in one of those bars.
One is Marshall Dill Pickle in?
Well, we'll have to look in each one.
We haven't got time for that, Pokey. Look! Marshall Dill Pickle!
Well, now, what's the trouble there, son?
That monster is after us, Marshall.
Monster, eh? Well, son, you and your friend better get off the street then, because somebody's liable to get hurt. All right, monster. You're not wanted in this town. Now just get out of here before I have to shoot you.
We're done for, Gumby. Poor Marshall Dill Pickle.
Wait, Pokey! Look!
That monster ate my ice cream cone. And it is a super double dip, too.
Hey! All the monster wants is our ice cream!
Calling all kids. Calling all kids. Keep an eye out for these two birds. One calls himself Heckle, the other Jekyll. They're a pair of real comedians.
Dangerous Dan had a record of killings like no other man. A fast shooting outlaw with a heart just like lead, who could chew up a bullet and spit a man dead. Yippee-dee, yippee-do, yippee-dee-di-di-day, and them that lives by your gun goes the same way. Now his fame in the West traveled far, traveled wide, and every tough hombre was after his hide. But Dangerous Daniel took care of them all. He'd fan from the hip, and the critters would fall. Yippee-dee, yippee-do, yippee-diddly-di-di-day, and a clip by a gun will go the same way. One day toward the town he came riding real fast, a-looking for some harmless cowboy to blast. And so met his downfall, as all bad men should, by two tenderfoot barbers who trimmed him for good. Yippee-dee, yippee-do, yippee-diddly-i-di-day, them that lives by a gun will go the same way.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. And who's next? Next? Well, well, if it isn't Dangerous Dan.
I want service.
You do look nice with your hair parted. Say, he looks tough.
Make me pretty.
Yes, sir. Right away, sir.
Coming right up, sir.
At your service, sir.
You are making me very mad.
Oh, Dangerous Daniel, 'twas your vanity that brought you to town for a barber to see. You asked for a treatment you'll get. 'Twill be one I'm sure that you won't soon forget.
Yippee-dee, yippee-do, yippee-diddle-yi-di-day, then that little fire gun will go the same way.
Hello. And so ends the story of Dangerous Dan. No longer is he the same desperate man. And if you should visit the barber someday, you'll find poor old Daniel a-working away.
Yippee-dee, yippee-do, yippee-diddly-idee-day. Then that lips by a gun will go the same way.
Welcome back to the Wednesday Treasure House, this part of which is brought to you by all those good Kellogg cereals. You know, boys and girls, there are many different kinds of trees with many different names, but there's only one tree that tells you what your name and the names of your friends mean. Yeah, that's Kellogg's name tree, right? So let's pick a name, shall we? Here, pick one right here. See what we have here. We have a leaf, too. Very nice. Oh, the name is Gregory, Greg for short. Do you know somebody named Gregory or Greg? Well, it comes from a Greek word, the name tree tells us, and the Greek word meaning to be watchful.
Mm-hmm. If you'll be watchful, you'll see the captain give me a bowl full of Kellogg's Rice Krispies.
Why, I'd be delighted, Mr. Moose.
And if you listen carefully, you'll hear those nourishing bubbles of toasted rice go snap, crackle, pop when they meet the milk.
Listen. I can hear them talking.
I think they're trying to tell you something.
What's that?
I think they're saying, have a rice day, Captain.
Oh, yes, indeed. Thank you. Boys and girls, you do begin a rice day with a Rice Krispies breakfast. Right?
Rice. Right. I mean, right.
Right.
The girl of my dreams, boo, 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 each night you come to me when I'm asleep. You're driving me nuts every night when we meet. Why does it all have to be just a dream?
Who is she?
She's my dream girl.
She's marvelous. She's beautiful. Introduce me to her, will you?
How can I? I only meet her in my dreams.
Well, let's start dreaming. Dreaming already. Hey, wait for me.
I'm so glad you're here.
Ah, she's glad I'm here.
Aren't you going to kiss me?
A voice from heaven. So, a wise guy, eh?
Who is this uncouth creature?
I never saw him before.
You know me. Now don't deny it. You double-crosser. You two-facer. You know me.
Sure, I know you. You're my best friend.
Well, don't pull that again. All right. So far, so good.
Oh, Romeo.
crazy for you. You are crazy for me. We are both crazy together. Come with me to the Casbah.
You did it again. You did it again. Now get under that bed and stay there. No, you don't. No, you don't.
What happened?
Now listen, you. From now on, I'll do the dreaming for both of us.
Is there anyone here who objects to this marriage?
I object! On God!
Is this the right road to Calvada?
You're headed right, neighbor, but you better pass that town. They'll get every cent you got.
Sir, I'm not a gambling man. Good day. I didn't ask your opinion. Opinionated. Oh, pardon me, officer. I'm looking for the Sands. Yes, they're expecting me. I'm a little late. I hope the reservation is still open.
Oh, yes, sir. It's open. They're waiting. Go right in, sir.
The senator's coming here today, Dedham, and we have to get more millions to get those three lemons off the ground. This is our big day.
Oh, what a fantastic gambling room. Oh, look at them crowd around that dice table. And that, oh, I'll wager that roulette wheel has wiped out many a poor soul. Betting beyond his means. They're terrible. It's just shocking. And there's the Wheel of Fortune. Fortune for the establishment, that is. Oh, the odds are now.
How do you do, sir? I'm Mr. Forthright, and this is Mr. Dedham.
Oh, delighted. Oh, it's a fabulous place you have here. But I can't stand to see all the money going down the drain here. How much money do you figure it takes?
Well, frankly, sir, we feel 2 million would...
2 million? Oh, that's absolutely outrageous.
Calling Mr. Forthright. Mr. Forthright, General Clogg is waiting at the main gate.
Excuse me a moment, sir.
Slot machines. Oh, look at that row of one-armed bandits. Well, I can't get hurt. One little 50-cent piece. A little candy spirit here. Here it goes. Yippee! Three lemons! I win! A jackpot! An IOU? Oh, no, they don't. That's a shabby trick. Forthright, I'm on to you, you fraud. Now about those three lemons.
I can explain those three lemons.
Don't explain, just give me my payoff. Cash money.
Payoff? Forthright, I'm astounded. Security police, arrest Mr. Forthright. Stop him!
Don't let him get away. Follow me.
There he goes.
Hey, don't let him get away.
Well, he got away.
Well, you did your best, officer. Oh, look, look, there's that crooked slot machine I've been telling you.
Slot machine?
Watch. It won't pay off.
Darn, darn, darn. And now who fired off this rocket?
Is that you, Forthright?
Yes, I was hiding in this thing when it went off. I guess I'm the first man in space, eh, General?
Yes, you are, Forthright. Congratulations. When will you be back?
Oh, I'll be out of orbit in a month or two.
I salute you, Forthright, a true hero.
Thank you, sir. And would you call my wife, Mabel, and tell her I won't be home for dinner? For quite a while?
I'm not leaving this place until I get my winnings. What's coming to me? Mind a man, complete satisfaction. Is that clear? Well, that's better. Oh, but you folks certainly are stubborn. Oh, Magoo, oh, they can't bamboozle you. You never lost a fight yet. No, sir, my...
Hiya, fellas. How's the Jell-O coming?
Okay, Dave.
What's yours, Simon?
Black cherry Jell-O with ice cream on top.
Good. Theodore?
Red Jell-O with marshmallows in it.
Great idea. Alvin? Alvin?
I made orange pineapple Jell-O with a hot dog in it.
A hot dog? No, think of something else. Something everybody would love in Jell-O. Something really great.
Okay.
Meanwhile, I'll rehearse the commercial. Friends, presenting the chipmunks in What's for Dessert, a play about wonderful new ways to eat Jell-O. What's going on there?
Presenting Jell-O with Alvin in it.
This is the home of David Seville and the three chipmunks, Theodore, Simon, and Alvin. They live in a normal American neighborhood where nothing unusual happens, except for the neighbors. They just keep moving out. Occasionally, someone moves in. Well, let's look in on Dave and the boys. They live in an average home. And there's Dave now, deeply engrossed in the throes of creation.
Alvin, will you cut that out? Alvin.
Alvin!
Okay!
Here at the Seville residence, everyone does his share of work. Fellas, to what do you attribute your great success?
Teamwork.
Boys, I'm going to pick up some recording tape, but in the meantime, I want you to rehearse the new song.
All right, fellas. Come on. Let's get it over with.
Hello, boys. I'm your new neighbor.
Hey, neighbor. Howdy, neighbor. Hello, neighbor.
Boys, I've got a problem. I work nights. That means I've got to sleep all day.
He sleeps all day.
Unless I'm disturbed, and then I get very unhappy. Don't make me unhappy, boys. Bye.
All right, fellas. Let's try it again. Hello, neighbor. It's our neighbor.
As I was saying, boys, one more tweak and I'm going to get very violent.
I'm all set to record, boys. Let's really hit it.
Yeah, let's. What key, Dave? Meet our new neighbor.
When I'm sleeping, I can't stand tweeps. So remember, neighbor, no more tweeps. I said, no noise.
Shall we try it again, Dave?
Go! Gone too far, boys.
You said it, Dave. Our career is at stake.
There's no point in being rash, fellas. First, let's take a look around, huh?
My mother, mother's mother, father's mother, father's father's mother, Whistler's mother, mother of Pearl, Pearl, mother goose, mother earth.
Alvin, what's going on? Alvin!
Oh, no.
Okay, neighbor, you asked for it.
M is for the many things she taught me. Put them all together, they spell...
Mother!
Gee, I didn't know you guys like... Mother!
Mother!
That's beautiful. From now on, you're my friends. We'll be a quartet. We'll sing nothing but mother songs. I've written millions of them. Every day is Mother's Day for me. One for all and all for Mother. Who knows Mother better than Father?
Why is it that better?
Really, Alvin?
Sure. And you'll sound twice as good in stereo.
Really, Alvin?
Sure. Excuse me. I'll get you two microphones.
Fine, young man.
Here you are, sir. Hold them just like this.
Surely, Alvin. Just like this.
Wonderful.
There should be no season, reason or rhyme. You should remember Mother any old time.
Believe me, why is it that friendly and unreasonable?
Mother!
The next time you go looking for a special kind of toy, look for Cecil the Sea Serpent and Lovable Beanie Boy. Here's funny Cecil, a crazy kind of guy. You'll find you really love him, and here's the reason why. He's got a silly nose, and he's got no toes. And great big eyes that go round and round. Oh, and here's a surprise. He comes in this size, and this size. Now, if you pull the magic ring, Big Cease might say anything.
I'm coming, Beanie!
And here's Lovable Beanie Boy, another wonderful Mattel-made toy. He's got a little pug nose and a great big grin. And look at his cap. You can make it spin. With Beanie Boy, you'll find there's two. And the bigger one will talk to you.
Where is Cecil?
There goes a good kid.
Cecil and Beanie Boys are lovable and huggable. You can tell them a tell. They're swell.
Come go sailing with Beanie and the crew. We're off to meet a monster, so why don't you come too? He scares people from China to Rangoon. And now here's Beanie and Cecil in a Bob Clampett cartoon.
Beanie meets the monstrous monster. Beanie Boy, summon the crew.
Aye, aye, Uncle Admiral, sir.
Men, I'll give it to you straight from the shoulder, epaulettes. Our shipping lanes are being menaced by a monstrous monster. And that's the worst kind.
Gracious.
In this briefcase, I have top secret telescopic photos from the files of the FIB. Loaned to me by my friend, J. Eager. Now, these Navy stop-action photos show us what we're up against. He eats whole ships like they were anchovies, and he loves seafood, especially fish and ships. He adores ship's kebab, and he likes nothing better than a hull mess of spar ribs. Then he washes it all down with a tanker of oil, and then he tops it off with an after-dinner smokestack.
Goodness.
Well, men, that's our mission. Find the monstrous monster and destroy it.
Right.
Okay, men, take your positions. I'll take mine below in my bunk.
Golly, Cease, how will we find the monstrous monster?
Oh, Cease will track him down. An effective detective always uses a disguise when going amongst the underwater underworld to do a little private eyeballing. See you, boy. Good morning, officer.
What's up in the morning, sir?
Hi there, Snapsy Maxie.
Crazy man, crazy.
Why, it's Jack the Knife. How are you, you old cut-up?
I'm feeling sharp, man. Hoo-la, really sharp, man.
I'm sure glad that you're about.
Hoo-la.
Have you seen the monstrous monster?
Monstrous monster! Ah, no! I gotta cut out. Oh, wow!
You're cutting me short. Why, staring herring?
Look into my eyes, Cecil.
Okay, herring, knock off the staring bit.
Psst. Hey, bud. Bud? Come here a minute.
Oh, Louis the Loan Shark.
Hey, chum, rumor has it that youth is seeking a buzz on the whereabouts of the big one.
Right.
Now, this for Moolah? The price is right. Big M is near the fog bank.
Fog bank?
La la la, a wonderful day out here. Mike, it's like a supermarket on the ocean. Appetizer, salad, and greens. We put those two together, you know. Then there's entree and nuts. Dessert. Dessert. What can I buy for dessert?
Oh, shucks. Someone's pulling our sea legs. There ain't no monster around here.
Help, Cecil, help.
Benny, where are you, boy? Benny.
Over here, Benny. Cecil, over here.
I like it, I like it.
Help, Cecil.
I'm coming, Benny boy. Oh, that ain't...
Help, Cecil.
He's hurt our body.
Oh,
hurt Pussy. Oh, that monster.
Wee wee.
He's such a schmo.
Ooh la.
Let's go get him. Let him have it.
Cha cha.
Are we ready?
Wee wee.
Go, man, go.
Oh, my big toe. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my poor aching spine.
Look into my eyes. You are now a Mississippi steamboat.
I am? Oh, yes. My goodness gracious. Oh, dear me.
Cease, boy. You've done it again.
Flatterer.
And now, here are some of the sea people who made tonight's save possible.
Louis the Lone Shark, Snapsy Maxy, Snaring Herring, and Jacques the Knife.
Goodbye now.
And now to all of you, we'll just say so long for Petey and Cecil, and Uncle Captain and
his honest John. We really enjoyed being with you, but now we'll have to say...
Go on, kids, wind up your lids, we'll look for dinner soon.
With Beanie Boy.
And your obedient serpent in a Bob Frank Bedtime Blue.